Hey, can you drop by the biolab?
Nice place you found.
Clean air, plants, helps me think.
Something on your mind?
Maybe.
What the hell was that?
I know that look. It's just my biotics reacting to all this. I don't normally lose it like that. A huntress should have better control.
Huntress?
Another term for an Asari commando. I was one before the initiative. Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
You were a second in command. Were you friends, too?
He was more a mentor than a friend. Prickly old bastard. But I respected that. People treat geniuses like they're made of cut glass. I didn't care how smart he was. I think he liked someone not caring.
I know it's not the same, but I'm a good listener.
I hope you're as good at being Pathfinder. I said I wouldn't get in the way, and I meant it. But I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you? An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
You, me, side by side? I like the sound of that.
Don't be charming when I'm mad at you.
Are you? You're not glowing. Blushing, maybe.
Look, there's still the mission. A lot of dreams to fulfill.
So what brought you out to Andromeda?
Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here. Hi there.
Did you come out here with anyone? Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore leave. Nothing serious, though. Asari huntresses figure things out, but I was there for soldiering, not romance.
You're not technically military anymore.
Can't get anything past you, can I?
You were in the Alliance before you became a huntress, right? What made you join up?
My biotics. I was still living on my parents' cargo freighter when they manifested. Untrained biotic power on a starship means accidents. But we couldn't afford a tutor. The Alliance had implants, the training, everything. Old history now. Your turn. Remind me why you came to Andromeda.
I spent years watching pioneers go through the Arcturus mass relays. Off to glory, while I stayed behind. Then Dad's career collapsed. His AI research made him too toxic.
I heard. Must have changed everything for your family.
We needed to start over somewhere new together. Or as together as we could. So, Andromeda.
None of you writers ever think small, do you?
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But your room's got more of a view.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years on the Hyperion looking after your sister.
Happy to have you, Dr. DePiro.
I'll do my best. Now, hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
Being nervous means you understand what's at stake.
That's the problem. I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Kett specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Kett corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Kett?
Harry didn't tell you. I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
That's a very specific topic.
I grew up on Omega, lots of Krogan mercenaries. The best habitat outside T'Chunka. But we were discussing the Kett. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan.
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats his vegetables.
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tan. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Where are your friends? The other Krogan?
We found a place to plant our feet, make our own rules. Leaving the Nexus wasn't ideal, but we've managed.
So why did you leave?
Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Roshan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Krogan could have made a real difference on the Nexus.
Staying under those conditions would have just resulted in another mutiny. We have a much better shot at something good out here.
Can't argue with that.
These are the Pathfinder's quarters. Your quarters. Sam's router is down there, too.
Hello, Scott. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star. You have grown as a result, and so have I.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
Pathfinder Rider to Engineering? Repeat, Rider to Engineering. Shit, is this thing on?
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Rider, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Rider.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew, even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Ability to haggle with the locals? Great. But please tell me you're also good in a fight.
Like I said before, Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between, I do what I have to. We all have a personal stake in this. If it keeps going the way it's been, we're all dead. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later.
Pathfinder, help me with something? I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked Omni blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Right, right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your Alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy urban search terrain one? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on the patch. All civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I wanted adventure and mystery at the edge of known space. There was so much to see. Seems like a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder. Why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
I hoped my Alliance career would lead to adventure, exploring, hunting dangers in the dark. Didn't happen. Couldn't. But here, everything's new. And I want to see it all.
Oh, I don't hear idealist a lot. Everyone's cynical.
Back at you, Costa. Why'd you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story. But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
If it all goes wrong, it could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response, I'd focus on essentials. That's you and this team. Pathfinder leads to planets, leads to people. You've got your part covered. You've got this. I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
Pathfinder, making the rounds. Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out?
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, no telling what might fall off the Nomad when you're out there.
I'll take my chances. Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
I doubt you were the only one.
Yes, but it's a new thing for me, regret. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and, oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
We're exploring this cluster, eventually the galaxy. If your purpose is here, we'll find it.
Then the question will be, what will I do with it? In the meantime, you just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Spoken since orientation, have we?
It's all been so hectic, but I'm sure things will quiet down soon. Can't be worse than the Nexus.
You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home.
Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Does your brain ever take a breath?
Sorry, not really. Even my dreams are in time lapse. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that. Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Maybe you just needed more sleep.
We were out for 600 years. A special someone made the trip with me, and she woke up a different person. I've slept enough. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Then again... I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
Wow. It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often, as if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if the sacred could be diminished by the search for truth.
I wasn't questioning your abilities. You never have to justify yourself to me.
Thank you. I appreciate you saying that, truly. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector?
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
You mentioned something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I like the Tempest, but I'm not sure I'd travel between galaxies for her.
The Unknown Frontier had its charms, too. It's just strange not having the rest of the design team. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Cheer up, Callow. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
Not enough time to survey all. Anomaly detected. Deploying probe. Getting a scan.
Pathfinder, is it true? Or Setos?
We've thought that before.
But Eos is different now, right? Pathfinder.
All right, settle down. Give him space. Lieutenant Syax, Kendros's aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
Relax, Lieutenant. If there was ever a day to pop some champagne. It's such a
mess. Certainly. The initiative's finally back on track.
This is Hirik, one of the scientists from the tech lab.
What you achieve with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible.
With more military personnel out of stasis, those Ket won't get near your vault. Or our people.
We've taken some hard knocks, but this proves we'll always get up again.
Always.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.
Scientists have few answers, as the dark energy anomaly known as the Scourge limits travel and communication in the cluster. This is HNS.
Isn't what we wanted. You've shaken things up, Pathfinder.
My department actually has colonial affairs to direct. And you have new tools to help grow the initiative. AVP, ready for spending.
Sam said there was new functionality to discuss.
It's how the initiative was designed to support the Pathfinder. You and your team are out there making Andromeda viable. That empowers all of us. Hit a threshold. A new cryo group can be brought out. Want more security, like you chose at Prodromos? That's your call. Brekka will introduce the interface and handle minutia. All you need to do is decide what life in Andromeda means. No pressure.
Hello, Pathfinder. I am Cryo Deployment Administrator Vladimir Brekka, C-63 Galati. Your first task is to decide irrevocably the course of every life in the Initiative.
Whoa, that seems like... too much.
Yes, of course. But now you respect what we're doing. Andromeda viability and the Nexus thresholds are your tools, your reward, and our future. How can I help?
What's the rundown on AVP?
Much of the preparation in the Milky Way was determining how to measure success. Thresholds are about capacity, but this is about cost, what we can actually afford to support. Points aren't the most elegant system, but it makes it clear. The more you earn, the more we can deploy.
How are you measuring thresholds?
It's based on resource estimates and the general stability, a metric of acceptable scope and risk. The more you achieve, the greater capacity we can accommodate, the more the initiative can do for you. Simplest explanation? The more you do, the more room we have to grow.
So, I decide what groups to wake up. Won't everyone be out eventually?
Absolutely. But there's an order to things, lines of support. You can't deploy an omelet without first deploying eggs, and eggs won't get you steak. Except it's people, and how all our lives begin.
All right, Brekka. Where do I start?
The interface is active and will respond only to a Pathfinder. It's ready for your first selection. You may begin shaping the initiative at your leisure.
Hello. Director Tan is expecting you.
Last time I was here, this was a storage closet.
Pathfinder Hall just needed a Pathfinder to open.
We're still getting the commons area ready. Hydroponics is only at partial capacity.
Not good enough.
We don't have enough people. My workers need a break, Tan.
I sympathize, but not until our survival is no longer at risk. Now please excuse me while I meet with our Pathfinder. Hey, Ryder. Addison told me about the outpost. You're the hero of the hour.
I guess this is one bet that paid off.
Point taken. Always revel in your victories.
That's why I'm standing here.
Oh, I never doubted you. It was the others. They don't share our vision, Ryder, of a prosperous future in Andromeda.
Due respect, Director Tan, but you don't know me.
Oh, I think I do. Your ingenuity speaks for itself, Ryder. Deciphering the vault, alien terraforming, it's not how we imagined all this, but a good Pathfinder improvises. And a great one hangs it on the wall. Yours are the first trophies to grace Pathfinder Hall. You're a symbol now, Ryder. A reason for people to believe.
It wouldn't have been possible without my crew. They're a talented bunch.
But you're their beacon.
Careful. You'll end up adopting you, Ryder.
Ah, my staff.
Colleagues, you wouldn't be looking to cut us out, would you, Tan?
I remind you, I am the director of the initiative.
Acting director.
This isn't the time for arguing over who gets to be king. Too much is at stake. We should be cooperating.
That's what I've been saying since we arrived.
Then I look forward to winning our Pathfinder's support.
Though I worry about your decision on Eos, Ryder. A military outpost won't help feed the Nexus, not the way scientists might have.
But it will protect us from a growing list of threats.
And we could argue about it all day long, as we always do. The decision was made. Now we move on. What is your plan for moving on, Ryder?
We have a lead on the terraforming network. I need to take the Tempest deeper into the sector to investigate. If the other Golden Worlds are where they should be, this could get us closer to them.
Careful. The Ked are scouring the cluster for remnant technology. You'll end up in a fight, for sure. You might also run into exiles. They didn't leave the Nexus on good terms.
And we still need more outposts. They're important to expanding the station.
Though with Ark still missing, this could be a chance for Ryder to search for them. Yes, I think that's best. You have my permission.
I wasn't really asking for it.
Of course. I support that kind of enthusiasm.
Right.
Ryder, this is Harry, back on the Ark.
Go ahead.
We may have found a way to talk to your sister, sort of. Drop by when you can, Hyperion Medbay.
Will do.
A reminder, you have AVP outstanding.
Right. Have to talk to Addison's assistant about viability perks. Sounds useful.
The whole mood of the Nexus has changed since Eos. You really can feel it. New outpost, a Pathfinder's help, people waking up. It's a fresh start.
Third time's a charm, if you happen to have a Pathfinder around.
Can't always rely on luck. From here, it's hard work. But it's damn good to know we're on the right track.
All personnel, be aware of any suspicious activity.